coming to you live. Is that loud or what?
Broadcasting live from the Jet Surf Houston studio, a show immersed in the people,
extreme water sports,
real estate,
live music,
yacht clubs,
kayaking,
canoeing, the lifestyle of the waterfront capital of Texas. Did we mention there's a lot of boating and sailing? Oh no.
Can we cut that?
I think I'm seasick.
Let's go!
Weekends on the Water with veteran and professional extreme water sport athlete Jordan Dablin of Jet Surf Houston and Scene Magazine publisher John Ennis.
That is right. This is Weekends in the Water, and we're back in the 4,000 square foot Jet Surf Texas studio and showroom along the north shore of Clear Lake in the heart of the waterfront capital of Texas. My name is John Ennis, and as always, I'm proud to be joined by Army veteran, extreme water sports competitor, and Jet Surf Texas founder, Jordan Dablin. How goes it, Jordan?
What's up, John? How you doing, man?
Man, doing awesome. It's hot out.
It is super hot. It is coming up on the 4th of July.
4th of July weekend. So we're going to do a special July 4th holiday weekend show.
That's right, man. We got a lot to preview. There's so many different things going on, like fireworks everywhere. Well, I'll just get right into this. Fireworks are back, because I know there was a time where people would come down to the water, they'd watch fireworks, you know, Nassau Bay, and the Clear Lake Chamber of Commerce did them, and there was so much going on, and then it kind of dwindled away there for a few years. And I don't know the exact years where it kind of shut down, but I remember even living in San Antonio, coming down that weekend to visit family, and then being prepared to have fireworks, and it, like, not happening.
Oh.
Nowhere on the water. And then Kima kind of started doing them, and then they all started trickling back, and now literally everywhere, like every county around us, you know, Baytown, Galveston, everything on the water, Nassau Bay, League City, Kima, everybody's doing them between Saturday, Sunday to the 4th. There's going to be 4 days of fireworks.
Hey, we're the fireworks capital of Texas this upcoming weekend.
I'm telling you, yeah. So you're going to be seeing them from all angles if you're anywhere in the Clear Lake area. So it's exciting.
Absolutely. You know, and we're talking before the show that the Kima Boardwalk kind of has scaled back their weekly fireworks show.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that used to be every Friday in June and July.
That's right.
Or at least every Friday in June leading up to July 4th.
As we were talking earlier, John, they've done both months. You know, they've done June and July. They've done Fridays. It's kind of gone back and forth. Inconsistent, but they definitely do fireworks every year at least two or three times. And I've got to say, even though they're not doing them every Friday this year, the last show they did on June 2nd to kick off the summer, it was an incredible show. If I hadn't talked about that on air, it was really, really nice.
Awesome.
I believe I posted a video, but it might have been the best Kima show I've seen. New fireworks I hadn't seen before, bigger and better than ever. You know, was the solid, you know, 12 or 15 minutes. It wasn't just a 5-8 minute run, which is, you know, kind of common. You know, it's still amazing, but they do the full thing. So I'm thinking for this 4th, it's going to be big, but they're competing with League City. League City's got a huge one going on at Hometown Heroes,
I think. That's true.
So,
I believe you're right. We'll get to that. And also, you know, you mentioned Baytown.
Yeah.
You know, and I've known this for years. You know, Baytown, the Parks and Rec Department in Baytown, they really put together a great series of events over the July 4th weekend. I mean, they've had...
You've talked highly.
Yeah, they've had REO Speedwagon. I've done marketing for. I did marketing for them for probably about at least 10 July 4th weekends in a row. And they bring in name acts. And just to tease a little later on the show, they're bringing in some names I recognize. They're bringing some big names this year too. But
I feel like we're on the map right now with performers. You know, between what kind of Barge was doing, and then just all the festivals, this area kind of getting back out in the community. A lot of community events, and they're hiring known country western stars and bands and things, tribute bands.
True.
And the Lagoons have an act. So
yeah.
This whole area, there's a lot of concerts. I feel like a lot of performers are getting a lot of love down here right now.
I agree.
So it's kind of cool.
Well, you know, the live music scene has always been very dynamic down here. It's always been a little different than it. You know, I mean, this area is not just your typical suburb of Houston, and we've talked about that before. But, we have so many special live music venues for all different genres of music, you know. And
long history of entertainment.
Yeah, long history of entertainment. And you're right. I mean, there's literally a national act playing tomorrow at Scout Bar. Rehab, you know, you probably already can, a couple songs might be going in your head by, so there's a lot going on. You know, this whole weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then all the way through July 4th, there's sailing events, there's live music, there's sand sculpture showdowns in
Galveston.
Oh, wow.
What's going on with the sand sculpture?
Yeah, I guess we can do we'll jump in there. You know, so this is not to be confused with the AIA, Houston Sandcastle Competition, which will be taking place this year. The 36th annual event will be taking place Saturday, August 12th.
Yeah, this is a pre-thing, right?
This is
like warm-up.
It's kind of cool because there's even free sandcastle building lessons from a pro.
That's right.
It's called the Galveston Sand Sculpture Showdown, July 1st and 2nd, East Beach in Galveston, which is also where the AIA Houston Sandcastle Competition will be later on this year in August, mentioned, August 12th.
At East Beach, you said?
Yeah,
yeah,
which is
both,
a change.
Both at East Beach,
I think sometimes, I've been to it. It does move around.
Yeah, yeah,
especially the AIA, you know. There's going to be a showdown from 9 to 6 p.m. on both, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. on both July 1st and 2nd, which is Saturday and Sunday.
Wow.
You know, there's going to be master sand sculpture artists as they compete for bragging rights. So you can witness them at work, but you also get to play a role in determining the winner by voting. And then also, like I said, there'll be free sandcastle building lessons from a pro, and he says receive free sandcastle building lessons from a professional sandcastle builder during the sandcastle sculpture showdown. The lessons will take place at 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. and 3 p.m. I assume those 2 days, Saturday and Sunday. And, it looks like a really cool event, you know, family-friendly, because not every event that we're going to mention today is family-friendly.
Right, sure. It's a family-friendly weekend, but, there's all sorts of festivities. Not to go too far into, Sam sculptures and stuff, but I recently went to the Texas Sand Fest, and I hadn't been in a long, long time, and so I was super excited to go to the AIA this year and just kind of compare them and support the Galveston one. I wanted to kind of just see the differences, but I got to say, I've heard really good things about AIA.
Oh, yeah.
And I know some people that are actually sponsors of it. We're excited to get down there this year and even check out this pre-show. But, man, Texas Sandfest, it was really cool to see the different levels, the newbies, the kind of amateurs, the semi-pro, the pros, and kind of how they develop. And they start at these classes and kind of work their way up, and they go to the amateur class, and then they're semi-pro, and then they start traveling, and then they get paid to, like, compete in these. I mean, because I don't even know if these guys come out there for free. The stuff they're creating, right. I feel like they're getting paid. You know, it's and then they win some glory or some more money or something.
Nice.
But it's just amazing to see that, the different levels and what they're able to do. So that should be a lot of fun.
I'll admit, building sandcastles, literally castles and fortresses with walls and moats and all that, that's kind of a family tradition with me and my kids now.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, we'll be heading down to Galveston for the wife's birthday party birthday weekend, not this coming weekend, but the next weekend. So we'll be down there. The Airbnb condo right there on the beach,
and start practicing.
Yeah, so we'll be making stuff. It's funny because there was a time where we would make sandcastles, and my son's 4 years younger than my daughter. When he was real young, then he would be Godzilla and he would just tear it all up.
Oh, of course, yeah.
And it really upset my daughter, but
no way.
Since then, she's gotten revenge a couple times.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, but because she never forgot.
Oh,
but,
she waited until he had the best one ever.
Until he actually participated and had pride in it, and then she reminded him what it feels like to
the tsunami came in and wipes it out. Yeah, that's funny.
But yeah, no, I mean, I love making sandcastles.
Yeah.
Just got to stand up every once in a while and kind of stretch out because, after sitting on sitting for too long, you get kind of tight. But
so that's down in Galveston. That's down at the beach. But obviously, me and John are up here, cheerleaders for all of the Gulf Coast. But Clear Lake is where we're at. And there's so much going on over here. They're going to be doing fireworks in Galveston. They got the sandcastle thing going on. But back to this area because, man, like I said, we got fireworks and
Much going on, and really the events start tonight, actually. I know there's a comp.
Right.
Well,
it really does start tonight.
There's live Tuesday. There's live music tonight, but also I think tonight's might be the Commodore meeting for an event taking place this weekend, which is the Galveston Bay Cruising Association Cruise and Rum Race Series, which this will be the second event on July 1st, which is Saturday.
Who does this?
So thing? This puts on, it's by the Galveston Bay Cruising Association, okay. The right. GBCA.
Yeah.
And actually, you know, if you ever want to know what's going on as far as sailing regattas in this area, go to gbca.org. And there's, they pretty much, I mean, this is a little behind the curtain, a little secret, all, you know, many years of updating the sailing calendar for the Scene magazine.
Right.
You know, I used to bounce around from four different yacht clubs, five different sailing groups, and, you know, try to figure out what was going on for the print edition. And then at some point, I think it happened later on, but at some point, some the people from the Galveston Bay Cruising Association decided to just make a Google Docs calendar of all the events happening in Galveston Bay and Clear Lake and
they,
you know, the waterfront capital.
Reconned it.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. So then it gave me one place to go, you know, for all the events. You know, they have all the events that Lakewood Yacht Club's putting on, Houston Yacht Club, Corinthian Yacht Club, the Clear Lake Racing Association, you know, the Galveston, I mean, waterfront.
Once you become a valid source and you're known and you're up to date, it's like starts becoming a thing and it's expected. So they have to keep up with it now because it's people know yeah. they go there. You
true,
know?
True.
So, yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Occasionally, I'll still find a couple events on the Houston Yacht Club race, you know, some sailing events that aren't, you know, in there. But yeah, they do a great job. So if you had to pick one website to go to find out, hey, is there a sailing regatta along the waterfront capital of Texas this weekend? First of all, the answer is probably yes.
Yeah,
and,
that is. Yeah,
especially right now.
100%.
You know, matter of fact, there's probably two different events going on
oh, yeah.
you know, on a given weekend right now. But yeah, if you want to go to a website, go to go to gbca.org. That's the Galveston Bay Cruising Association. And like I said, they've got the they've been doing their used to be called the Rum Race Series. Well, it's now sponsored by Cruzan. Run.
Yeah,
yeah, and yeah. So they put on the first event in June 17th. Then the next race is July 1st, then July 15th, July 29th, August 19th, September 2nd, and September 23rd. So this is just an ongoing race series in Galveston Bay, sponsored by Cruzan Rum.
All right, nice.
Yeah, so that's and we're kind of skipping around here.
Yeah,
you know, let's throw some live music at you. There's two acts coming up tomorrow night that I'm. You know, two different concert opportunities that I'm real excited about. I kind of teased the Rehab Revival Tour, which is tomorrow at Scout Bar, and that has Rehab, then Scotty Austin, former frontman of Saving Abel, and then Framing the Red are the three feature acts. And then also, act that's coming back to T-Bone Tom's that I don't think's been there in a little while, the Blackguards is showing up at T-Bone Tom's tomorrow night, Friday, June 30th. And you know, just a you know, kind of a, I think it's stout Irish rock is how they describe themselves,
nice.
And really a fun band, high energy band to check out. You know, go over to T-Bone Tom's, you know, get you some pelican eggs, maybe have a steak or something.
Yeah,
you know,
pelican
or some,
eggs.
Yeah, and enjoy some enjoy the Blackguards out on the what used to be called the backyard. Now I think it's the gosh, who sponsors the music stage now? It was Landshark Music Stage, I think, or something like that. Yeah. But
I feel like Landshark's done a bunch.
And yeah, so that's you know. And back to the Scout Bar, doors open at 7. Show starts at 7:30. And the Blackguards, you know, usually by rule of thumb on Fridays, you know, just get there, try to get there early. I mean, you know, it does fill up, but they get people in and out pretty quick, you know. And they got a huge patio and bar there, so perfect opportunity to watch the Blackguards. And those are two live music events coming on Friday. We mentioned the sailing event, Rum Race on Saturday. We mentioned the Sand Sculpture Showdown on Saturday and Sunday. And you know, guys,
so is there nobody doing fireworks on Saturday and Sunday? It's only going to be the 3rd and the 4th. League City's on the 3rd. Kima's on the 4th. When is Nassau Bay? I'm curious.
All right, so League City, they're going to have their, like you said, their firework extravaganza is going to be at the Chester L. Davis Sportsplex. It says 6 to 9 p.m.
It's not. I misspoke earlier when I said Hometown Heroes. Yeah,
well,
is it the one? Well, there's something happened
there's something
over there.
Yeah,
too,
yeah,
though.
Yeah. So Monday on July 3rd is
like
the fireworks
the freeway.
Extravaganza. At the Sportsplex.
Behind Mac Hike.
Yeah. And but then on Tuesday, July 4th, is Citizen Appreciation Day at Hometown Heroes Park. That's 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And, you know, they got events going on all month long in League City. Let me scroll down here and see. Okay, let me grab. Yeah, my Baytown stuff didn't didn't save, but we'll pull that up later. But, you know, let's see here. We've got July 2nd. You know, Tejano Music Nights is every Sunday in July at the Kima Boardwalk. So there's that's going on Sunday, July 2nd. Kicking It Country is about to start up in July, starting July 12th. The Chad Cook Band and Jake Worthington. But, and then, of course, you got Rock the Dock, which has been ongoing. And the next Rock the Dock show is going to be July 6th with Garden Grove and Just a Girl. So that's pretty, actually, I've seen that act. It's a Sublime tribute band is Garden Grove. And then Just a Girl, as you could imagine, is a No Doubt tribute band. So Kima's rocking. They got a lot of events. And while we're mentioning the Kima Boardwalk, one thing I'll mention, and of course, I happen to be sitting next to a Patriot right now, Jordan Davlin, who's served our country. Think what didn't you say you turned 19 over in Iraq or something like that we won't get into ages, but
no, it's funny. It is funny. I turned so I joined the military at 19, towards the end, you know, being 19. I turned 20 in basic training, and then I was already deployed by the time I was 21, so I turned 21 in Iraq, and then I was extended in combat for an extra 3 months, so I did 15-month tours, so I turned 22 in Iraq.
Okay, respect,
so it was,
man.
It was 20 in basic, 21 in Iraq, 22 in Iraq.
Respect.
Yeah, so it's just interesting. Yeah,
yeah, but, yeah. No, I love it.
Those days are over. Yeah, right. That was a long time ago.
Jordan's going, where are you going with this, John? Well, anyway, so the Kima Boardwalk, the Galveston Pleasure Pier, and the Downtown Aquarium have a promotion called the Patriot Pass.
Yeah,
cool. June 30th through July 4th, three parks, one pass, $69.99. Enjoy unlimited admission on rides for all three parks July 4th weekend. So, and, you know, that's a steal. That's a good deal. I would take advantage of that. Matter of fact, I still need to, you know, there's a roller coaster on the Pleasure Pier that I've not tried, you know, that I've been excited about, the Iron Shark. It's a Gerstlauer.
Oh my, you haven't tried it?
No,
I haven't either, but I know you're an enthusiast.
Well,
so.
I
don't even mess with roller coasters anymore.
No, that one actually I've yet to try, and I'm, you know, and it's a really cool, it's got like a beyond 90 degree drop and everything. So yeah, that might be the call to action to try that. But yeah, so that's kind of a cool special going on in you know, for this upcoming weekend. Actually, I guess you know, June 30th tomorrow. So you get your pass and you probably hit all three parks, and you actually have, I guess it gives you 5 days, so you have all the way through Tuesday. So yeah, you can get some serious value out of that. You know, it's what you make of it, right? Those kind of passes. You know, you could pay $69.99 and never leave your house, or you could pay $69.99 and hit those parks every single day that you can, and, you know, get all kinds of crazy value.
Yeah. And real quick, I'll just mention, so it's not necessarily over here by the water, but it is on the water, because they do it I'm trying to figure out what the park. I was actually just there for an event, but they're doing the Shell Freedom Over Texas fireworks in Houston, so that'll be a big event, and it's on the bayou down there on the water in Houston. If you're a listener from the Houston area and you're not gonna be able to make it to watch fireworks down by the water here.
Nice. And I'm gonna try to pull up the Baytown information, because they've got a series of events,
they got a big thing going on.
No,
over
they take July 4th seriously over in Baytown, trust me.
I feel like League City and Baytown are like trying to pull from each side of the lake, you know.
Well, you know, I remember years ago, or not too long ago, being at a State of the Lake conference where you have all the mayors from around the Clear Lake, general Clear Lake area, at the time the mayor of League City, told Matt Wiggins, who was the mayor of Kima at the time, you know, it was Tony Rath. Tony, gosh, I forgot her last name, but anyway, she goes, Matt.
Oh, Tony Randall?
Yeah, Tony Randall, yeah. She goes,
I know
Matt,
Tony.
Yeah. She goes, Matt, we're going to try to pull as many people, you know, into League City. You know, we're going to try to steal them, you know, because obviously you have to pretty much drive through League City to get to Kima, depending on, you know. So she told him flat out, man, we're gonna start, you know, grabbing all those tourists, Matt.
That's funny.
And they've done a lot. I mean,
they have. They're on, That's funny. Yeah, I've actually worked with Tony. She's actually knows a little bit about the water sports business. So I've worked with her. They own a lake in League City off 96 called, I don't want to put all our information out there, but I think this is known, you know, but they own Lake Longhorn.
Okay,
and, so we've worked with them and done some lessons, and at one point we even had a track set up on Tony's property. The old, yeah, League City mayor. So that's funny.
I remember that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So small world.
All right. Here we go. We just pulled up the Baytown stuff.
Baytown.
Yeah. So this all is happening at Bicentennial Park, 1001 Market Street, Baytown. It's Monday, July 3rd, Tuesday, July 4th. So, you know, July 3rd is kind of going to be a little bit more let's see here. Let me scroll down here and look at this stuff. So July 3rd looks like, you know, it's going to be sunny. It's maybe kind of a Tejano scenario a little bit. Sunny Sojedo, DJ Boris, and Signo. But then I saw some billboards for this. You know, the headlining act on July 4th, there's all kinds of acts on July 4th. The headlining acts is Grammy award-winning artist Leanne Rimes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw that. Wow.
And for some reason, I thought Slim Thug was going to be performing, but maybe
Slim Thug.
Yeah, I think you know, but you know how that works. Things change. Things are fluid.
Some of these artists. Houston rappers, they bring a big crowd. People right. really love them, and they do a lot for the community. We saw Bun B at Surf, you know, festival in Galveston a couple months ago, or you know, actually it was like, yeah, it was like a month and a half ago. But that was nice. A lot of fun, and people were super excited to see Bun B. And I know Slim Absolutely. Thug has a big following, and yeah.
There's a lot of local Houston rappers that have.
Oh, there is big, a man. Yeah. Ton. If you look up Houston rappers, there's almost 100 rappers from Houston. Now, granted, only 20 or 30 of those are big names or mainstream. But if you're from Houston, you might recognize 30 or 40 of those names.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And again, 20 or 30 of those guys are national guys. And some of them are older now and they, you know, but, they had some old albums, but there's 80-100 like rappers that have had labels, records, you know, done concerts in Houston. It's a huge music community for that. Definitely New York, Los Angeles, Houston, New Orleans, North Carolina, Florida. That's like and then St. Louis.
Right.
That's pretty much. That's where the rap's at.
And even Nelly made it big in St. Louis, he's repping the Houston Astro Rainbow jersey back in the day.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Which, of course, was designed by Bay Forest resident Jack Immuni. Lives right here in Waterfront Capital, Texas.
Drake spends a lot of time in Houston. He reps Houston. He's not from Houston.
Well, 50 Cent moved here, man.
People are very intertwined, even if they're not from here.
Yeah.
The scene is huge.
No state income tax. That might play a role in some people relocating here. I don't know.
And if people haven't forgot, Beyonce's not a rapper, but man, she's from Houston.
Oh, yeah.
And, she's like royalty, you know, here. Yeah.
So I still remember I got a promotional photo for Destiny's Child, and it wasn't even the lineup that ended up making big, although Beyonce was definitely in it, maybe Kelly Rowland, but I think, you know, anyway, but I mean, this is back in 98 or 99.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I was working at a internet startup in Houston, a media company. Yeah, so I remember that. I wish I would have kept that little black and white promo photo.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, we claim Beyonce for sure.
So we've been talking a lot about 4th of July and a lot of, you know, what's coming up this weekend. And it's super exciting because the party's about to start. But we just came off of a
That's
weekend
true.
That was pretty crazy. So if Texas. You guys didn't tune in last week, the Texas Outlaw Challenge just happened, and that is just a huge, phenomenal event that happens every year.
It's become a monster.
It has. Like John says every time and previewed on Wednesday, I mean, it just the heads in beds, the amount of money it draws, the people coming from out of town, out of state, you know, I mean, there's even been international stuff.
Yeah, there's the year I met you at the Texas Outlaw Challenge, there's a boat from Abu Dhabi, there's boats from Canada, there's boats from South
Sweden,
America.
Yeah, I mean, technically Husky was from, was from Sweden.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Husky Chocolate, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
I think the boat was from, St. Louis or something, right? I mean, I guess that's where that one company is, MTI or whatever.
It was stored in a hangar at Ellington Field,
right,
and we've talked a lot about that.
Yeah.
But so Texas Outlaw Challenge happened, and it was incredible. I did not get to enjoy as many events as I would have liked to.
It's almost physically impossible to enjoy it all, man.
Just, I mean,
there's
literally
too much going on.
It is a rat race trying to, you know, I mean, it's a good thing because you don't have to do it all. But the guys that do it all, that are like checking in and going to all of it, you are on boat or by car, you are jumping around. I mean, there is like 3-4 parties a day, and not parties, but just get meet and greets.
Right.
You know,
yeah. Oh,
pull
yeah.
your boat up, have some food, and you know, hang out. These guys don't get to hang out all the time, and getting to see their boats and catch up and all that. I mean, they work hard, they play hard. The energy this last weekend was insane.
Agreed. Yeah.
I think there was more boats out on Clear Lake than in 2018 when you saw me riding.
Okay. I believe it, man. It seems like things have really picked up.
They were lined up out there. You know, there was 100 boats probably lined up.
Wow.
And, you know, they weren't all huge boats or anything, but they were out there watching, lined up. That was fun to see. And then, yeah, all the pool parties, you know, again, I wasn't able to make it to the pool parties, but, I think they were all successful. I think everybody had a good time and they cater these things. And, you know, there were some bikini contests, so many different like bars and places involved. Marine Max does a gala.
Oh yeah.
Like I said, we previewed all this stuff and we had an awesome guest on last week that previewed everything. You know, Miss Jolanta came on and was able to do a great job. But, yeah, it all happened. And it happens every year successfully.
Yeah.
A couple of my friends got trophies. Cash Schubert, he got a trophy, I think, for best in show at the showdown in Kenya.
Okay,
got all the boats lined
up.
I was showing a lot of people photos of that. That was – and I was riding the skateboard through there.
Oh, nice.
So I had the Jetser
electric
skateboard.
Yeah, the electric skateboard.
And was riding through, checking out the boats and doing some filming. And so that was fun. And yeah, they just, the amount of energy that brings, you know, over those 5 days, because again, it starts on Wednesday.
Yes.
Me and John previewed it last Wednesday, and then it goes all the way till essentially, you know, Sunday. But I mean, people aren't really leaving town until Monday.
Right.
You know, this is like, you know, a 5-6 day thing.
Yeah.
It's insane.
No, the local CVB loves it, man. Convention Visitors Bureau, heads and beds, great for hotel, motel, tax money. But it raises so much. I mean, just so much money comes into the area. All the restaurants, live music venues, but then also all the money raised for charity. So
that's right. Yeah,
great event. I mean, like I mentioned last week. I mean, it started out as, you know, as a poker run, 1 day poker run, and now
there's
like
three
this,
helicopters.
Oh yeah,
you know yeah yeah. Follow, yeah, so.
Yeah, there's literally helicopters flying all over, getting aerial shots because I mean, there's really very few times where there's a collection of all these boats together in one place. I mean, we're talking. I mean, I can't even imagine how much money worth of boats, you know, I mean, you know, I've learned how now, I mean, you know, you mentioned some boats are small, but yes, some of the small boats probably still cost $100,000.
No,
right?
And when I was talking about small boats, I was just talking about viewers.
Right.
People are bringing their dinghies out, their yachts out, their speedboats out and lining up on the water. It wasn't all like, $500,000 power boats, but everyone's lined up having a good time watching. No, every boat going by, big or small, is big money, John.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
No,
I've learned that. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And sometimes even just because it's bigger don't mean it's faster. I mean, you know, there's a lot that goes into all that.
That's true.
There's a boat, you know, Team Gone Again, you know, he's got a boat that's not the longest boat in the stable, but boy, is that sucker fast. And I think we talked about that last week. He's number two on that list.
He
ain't getting knocked off that list anytime soon. And if I had to guess, he could be going to number one soon. He's been doing some work and...
Okay.
That boat's going to hit the water again soon.
Okay, yeah. It's been a couple years, right?
It has, and they make progress, and there's different things happening. I stay in touch with Kenny, and, I think that we'll see it on the water here soon. You know, if not this year, definitely probably next season or maybe this end of the season. Maybe not in Houston. You might see some test runs, but he may get into some contests and stuff. But, yeah, there's some things going on. I don't want to speak for him, but I know he's excited, and I think he wants to get the boat back out there, and he's working on it. I mean, that's a 200-mile-per-hour boat.
Right.
You know,
like, can you imagine 200
you know,
miles an hour?
Yeah, I mean, he hits 160, 180 all the time, and you know, I think he's trying to do more. So he's trying to maybe get to that number one spot.
Wow.
Yeah, you know. And he may not get to pilot the boat. He may get to, you know, but somebody is going to be taking that boat to the next level, you know. So that'll be really exciting.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, very successful event again. Gosh, you know, we're about, I want to say, probably about 15, 16 years in on that. I know the only year they've had the skip was, I think, 2020.
I think they said 16 years.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, 16. So,
no, I remember the very first one, man. I remember.
What would that put it at, 2007, kicked it off, or what?
Sounds about right. Yeah, so, I might have even thought 6, 7, somewhere in there.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, and I guess it wasn't really. It was, you know, earlier in the year.
When I was in high school here, and hanging on the lake. No, this was not happening.
This is relatively new. Yeah, there's always been other events, other tops
and poker runs,
and you know, and even going back in the old school days, back when they had the hydroplanes on Clear Lake for a couple of years with the Miss Budweiser and all that. Back when I was a young lad, you know, we're talking about probably like 83, 84, somewhere in that range. They eventually had to leave the lake just because, I guess, you know, there wasn't the lake, you know, is actually in a lot of places pretty shallow. So, sure. Yeah. So I think that became a little bit of an issue for the hydroplane races. But yeah, no, this, you know, I guess I'd say this area does kind of have a history of powerboat events. You know, obviously it's known for sailing too. You
back
know,
to Red Adair. I mean, these guys have been pumping, you know, engines and fast boat. I mean, that's what's so cool about this lake is, yeah, you have the sailing, the power boating, the racing, it's not just one type of boat
here.
It's a very diverse boating community.
Yeah.
And I was talking to some people a few weeks ago and explaining to them, they didn't realize, again, I was like telling them, I do Weekends on the Water, you know, this is a huge boating community. So me and John are, you know, right in it. I mean, this is just an amazing place to just talk about that. And they're like, well, I mean, how many boats are really here? And I'm like, it's the third largest boating community in the country. We're right tied with, like, San Diego.
Right.
But, and we said it a million times on the show. You've got Miami, Fort Lauderdale, like, kind of tied or kind of together. They're their own little beast down there. So, you know, South Florida is its number one. Yeah. It's always going to be number one.
True.
But then you've got New York. It's old money.
Boats,
it's been there a long time. Prior to there ever being boats down in Miami, there was boats up in New York.
Right.
And there's a lot of water up in New York, people don't realize. Yeah. So they're right there with it, too. Different type of boating. But, yeah, you've got Miami, Fort Lauderdale. You've got New York. And then we are right there tied with that San Diego market.
Correct.
You know, so it's interesting. People don't realize that, yeah, we are the third, fourth, whatever, right there. I mean, it's amazing. There is thousands and thousands of boat slips.
Oh, yeah. It's crazy. You know,
there's marinas with 1,000
right.
boat slips.
Yeah.
It's wild.
No, I think when you go by density, I think, you know, obviously I always try to figure out how can we be number one, but I think we're number one, you know, if you just take the Clear Lake region, you know, I think we're number one in density for boat slips. You know, that's not including even Galveston, Texas City. You know, there's some up in Baytown. Yeah. Obviously, there's, you know, I mean.
And you got houses on the water.
Right.
I mean, are those counted? You know, like, I think, by registered boats and then the amount of marine business. We've talked about that, too, how, you know, just like ports. There's tonnage, amount of ships, you know, traffic.
Containers.
Break
bulk. Yeah.
I think for the boating business, you know, there's only certain markets that have a whole industry that surrounds that area. There is so many boat repair shops, so many boat. I mean, this area.
There's upholstery shops that specialize in boat, you know.
Everywhere.
You know, boat,
here.
You know, cushions
so
and stuff, yeah.
It's there's a lot of support and infrastructure around that whole industry.
Also,
and not all communities have that.
Yeah, yeah. I agree. Yeah, I mean,
so
it's.
One out of 10 people around here work in the boating industry, at least in this area.
Yeah.
They really do.
Yeah. No, I believe it, especially with all the ports and everything, yeah.
Yeah.
And of course, we're coming to you right now live from the old bank sales, was it? Or no, Cameron Sales.
Yeah, Cameron
Sales. That's right, yeah.
Which is kind of a landmark building right here off Rebsdorf and Nass Road 1. Margaritaville's coming in across the street. But it sticks out like a sore thumb, and it's been here since, I mean, I don't know the exact year, but it's been here like 50 years.
Yeah,
so people know it. Yeah, it's been here for a long time.
It kind of almost looks like a blimp hanger in a way.
I'm sure, but, you know, we've really made a lot of changes that you know, the bones are strong.
That's true.
This
is
still building.
Yeah.
It ain't going nowhere. It hasn't gone anywhere. It's never flooded. The winds hasn't blown it down. We've had some storms, so the structure, the bones are strong. We've come in, we've redone the inside and given it some new life. And, you know, we're not a sell maker, but we're still in the boat business. And, it's been an awesome building for us, you know. Yeah, we're so excited we can broadcast out of here. But honestly, as much fun as me and John have in the studio, we like being on site. We
right,
like
yeah, remote, taking man. It live on the road.
Yeah, you know, being in all these cool venues that we're promoting and talking about. So
absolutely, yeah.
And one of these days, we're going to come live and do some video, I think, for a fireworks show. And I think that would be really neat. You know, like I said, definitely not going to do it this week. But, we'd like to do something like that, maybe down in Kima and, you know, try to come live and, you know, just talk about the fireworks.
That'd be cool,
Not that they'd be, like, listening while they're watching fireworks, but they can go back and be like, yeah, I thought,
like, wow, oh
yeah, yeah, oh, I thought that too. That yeah, awesome. Oh, John liked that one too. Yeah, no.
Yeah, but the fireworks show in Kima, I was thinking about New Year's Eve, catching it on the patio at Dan's Pizza. You know, that's actually, hey, that's a, because that was a little bit off the beaten path. You know, there's people
for New Year's, right?
Yeah, New Year's Eve. Yeah, that's actually a little little trick, a little secret. You know, for you, great spot to catch the fireworks because it's a little bit off the beaten path. Everybody's heading directly for the boardwalk, and literally, people were parking illegally and walking towards the boardwalk, and here I'm up on an elevated deck drinking some craft beer and having some Dan's Pizza with my family on New Year's Eve, dude. And it was beautiful. It was perfect. Yeah, I couldn't have asked for a better scenario there.
Yeah, man, we are big fans of Dan. If you have not had his pizza, he's got 3 locations.
And he's worked his way up, man. He really went from a pizza delivery driver, and now he actually, you know, after he opened his first spot and expanded it, he actually took over the spot where he started in the pizza game, and then he took over a spot in Kima, and you know, battled with the city for about a year.
Everybody battles with the city, you know,
he had some ambitious plans, so and he made it happen, man. He he's got a great beer selection at all his spots.
Yeah, that's another cool thing. Yeah, that he appreciates a good beer selection with the pizza. Yeah,
I'll just say something about the beer selection. You know, you can judge beer selections by a lot of different ways. You can count how many taps they have, how many different beers they offer, but a true somebody that really cares about craft beer, it's not how many taps they have, it's how many different distributors and self-distributing breweries they work with. Because you could have 100 taps and work with one distributor, and that's cool, and you'll probably have a lot of great beer. But when you only have 12 taps and you work with like 5 different distributors and 4 breweries, that's awesome.
That's
and
impressive.
That's kind of what Dan does. Yeah. You know, he works with the independents. He works with the small distributors that are carrying a couple niche, you know, breweries, and he doesn't take the easy way out.
We need to not take the easy way out and get a couple of those niche breweries in here.
Truth.
And have some delicious beer on deck, man.
That reminds me, I have a picture to show you once the show's over.
I'm thirsty.
Yeah. Yeah. Actually, I think we're empty, right? Yeah. It's funny how quickly the beer goes. Yeah. So also, you know, we talked about sailing this weekend. There's also the multi-hole rally number 2, sponsored by the Houston Yacht Club, going on Sunday. So that's, you know, so there are 2 sailing events, you know, going on this weekend. That'll be in the Galveston Bay, you know, out in Galveston Bay. It's so funny how many times now, you go over the Kima Bridge, you look off to the east, and you know, and there's always a regatta going on.
Yeah.
You know, so there's 100 sailboats out there, and you're like, that's awesome.
And we mentioned people viewing the Outlaw Challenge in their boats. One thing, we talked a lot about fireworks and all the different festivities going on this weekend, but one thing we didn't really talk about is if you have a friend or know a friend or have a boat, this is the time to take it out into the bay. And if you've never, I mean, I've actually never even watched fireworks from the bay, but I've heard amazing things. I love seeing all the different boats out there. You're going over the bridge.
Right.
You see it at nighttime. It's just
seems sparkling.
I don't know how many boats, but like hundreds of boats. And it's really neat. And that's the best view, you know, just watching them from the boat. So if you're able to get out there on a sailboat, powerboat, whatever, any type of boat, that's really going to be the best place to watch them this weekend.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. At least in Kima, you know. And then you'll get to see all the different ones going on around the lake as well. You may or may not, like I said, Lee City's on the 3rd, and you wouldn't be able to watch it from the boats there. But, man, they're just going to be popping off all weekend. It's going to be a good time. Yeah, so the next 5 days are going to be crazy.
Yeah, absolutely. And another event coming up, and you kind of alluded to it, and I think you might actually know more about it than me, is the ongoing Lagoon Fest series at Lago Mar. You know, on Sunday, they've got a tribute to country legends.
Yeah, I thought they had a concert this weekend.
Yeah, so they've got a tribute to Luke Bryan. Then they've also got a number of other the big Jordan band.
It's something Casey Dunn or
Chuck Shaw. Looks like John Swap Band. You know, and there may be more, but yeah. So there's You know, and that's a pretty cool venue, man. Wow.
We'll be there this weekend performing, and I guess we'll maybe try to catch that concert.
Awesome. Yeah. Yeah, that looks like, I mean, it looks like they're getting a pretty good crowd in there for those events.
They have a
right?
floating stage.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And one of our friends of the show, and a sponsor of one of my races, Oasis Construction.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Charlie Carey. Man, yeah, Charlie. He actually helped build the stage.
Oh, nice.
So he was one of the guys that helped design the floating stage for the concerts.
Very cool.
It's very neat. And then they have the band come over. They like pull them over on another like smaller little dock and pull them over to the floating stage, and then they get on the stage. So like they have to like get them to the stage, you know, and so it's funny watching the band come over, you know. So yeah.
Live music on the water.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so
yeah, I'm really impressed with what's going on at Lago Mar. I recently had a lease house that, you know, was, you know, I mean, I had so many people wanted it so bad real quick, leased it out real quick. But, you know, and I did some drone photography over the lagoon, and it's just beautiful, man. And they, man, they spend
largest in Texas.
And dude, they got a whole crew out there, like,
oh, yeah.
on two, I mean, you know, probably, I mean, just, you know, out there probably 24/7 almost.
They're closed,
man.
Mondays and Tuesdays, but Lagoon Fest Texas runs Wednesday through Sunday.
Okay.
And yeah, you know, weekends are the biggest, but yeah, it's jam-packed all summer. We're doing the water sports show on the weekends. They've got slides, bumper boats, cabanas, you know, floating cabanas, everything. Yeah, they got a restaurant. There's vendors. They have gelato.
It's like the Blue Lagoon, right? Isn't that the restaurant name now? Or
yeah, the Blue Lagoon.
Blue Lagoon Bar and Grill. Yeah.
So got some good food there. Yeah, no, it's a really awesome venue. You know, right in between us and Galveston, people are starting to call this, you know, this is kind of the new entertainment corridor.
Right. The Flyway and everything else coming here.
Oh,
man,
my God. Great
so
Wolf
much,
Lodge.
Great Wolf, man, I mean, that's coming along.
Texas City's spending money. League City's spending money. I mean, Lamarck is spending. I mean,
yeah,
it's really
truth.
Just picking up down here. Dude, they got a whole restaurant row with the Mall of the Mainland.
Right.
I mean,
yeah.
This is, there's a lot going on over there.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
So many new venues and bars and restaurants coming to the area. Yeah, it's exciting.
Over by Baybrook, I mean, they're going to run out of room to develop, you know, and I'm not complaining. But, yeah, I mean, it's just I'm excited about the new In-N-Out coming in.
There you go.
That's nothing to do with the water, guys.
Right. But hey.
But if you're coming down to Clear Lake, get some In-N-Out because it's going to be the only one within miles.
It's now an option.
Yeah, it will be soon.
Awesome.
So I think HEB helped make that happen, so good for them. Yeah, at least the In-N-Out leased the land from them.
But okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It's that whole,
is it right
HEB
there?
Anchored development.
Okay,
yesterday.
Yeah.
So.
Right there kind of off El Dorado and the freeway?
Yeah,
okay,
right
nice.
Next to Lowe's and
right.
Kelsey Siebel awesome. And all that. Yeah.
I haven't been into that HEB yet, but, you know, it looks pretty, you know, I love my HEB, you know, over there near the Reserve and Bay Oaks and, you know,
it's nice.
Pine Brook.
It's
yeah.
the same, but I mean, you know, they all have a little different, you know, setup, but it's all, you know, the same. They're both big HEBs. Yeah. What I was surprised, I didn't think it'd be as busy. I'm like, you know, it's a good location, but no one lives off the freeway. You know, I was like, I don't know how many people are, was it really necessary? Was that the best place for it?
Apparently so.
It's slam.
Yeah.
All day, every day.
That's what I was saying. Yeah.
I don't know. So,
the one over at Bay Oaks and the Reserve, I mean, it does get busy, but it's kind of like on the edge, right?
Yeah,
so, so it's not
so
crazy.
I guess people shop when they commute. It's not just like, go to the grocery store right by the house. They're like, on the way home from work, I'm going to stop, apparently, because that place is slammed.
Oh, dude, I mean, when we go to San Antonio and go to Fiesta Texas and SeaWorld, and we, you know, there's always this one hotel we stay at, and there's two HEBs, you know, almost, you know, within a mile of it, and we always, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've become a big HEB guy, I guess, you know.
Yeah, I lived in San Antonio for 7 years, so it was like forced down my throat. Yeah, Whataburger, HEB, and then there's a barbecue place. I can't believe that I can't remember the name, but they basically like built UTSA downtown campus. Bill Miller Barbecue.
Okay.
It, on every single corner in San Antonio, there's an HEB, a Bill Miller, or a Whataburger.
I believe it.
They run that town.
Right.
Oh, man. Nice. But no. Bill Miller donated all the land to UTSA downtown, and then I think they just like donated a bunch of money to like, expand it. Like, they're like, you know, building colleges.
Wow.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Like, I San Antonio. I'm glad you got out there this year, right?
Yeah,
or was it last year?
No. Man, we go a couple times. I mean, we have Six Flag passes, so,
okay,
you know,
yeah.
So we try good. to, Yeah, no, we definitely went during spring break, and we want to try to go at least once during the summer, you know, go hit the, you know, both Fiesta Texas and the water park inside. We used to have SeaWorld passes too, but I let those slide.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. you got to pick your spots.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah, definitely. Yep.
But we definitely, we loved SeaWorld and Aquatica, the water park there. Yeah, we were hitting that. Yeah, for the last 2 years, the theme of vacations have been rides and slides.
Yeah, that's right.
So we were trying to hit every water park and every amusement park in Texas.
Yeah.
Yes, I have a young son.
Yeah, and there's a lot of them.
Ones
you haven't
right?
even heard of. You know,
man, there's one up in Nacogdoches we hit recently.
The indoor ones now.
Yeah.
And then we're about to have one in our backyard.
Man, actually, we're planning on heading up to the Great Wolf Lodge, you know, here. We thought about doing it, this summer. Just to get that in before the one here opens up.
Just to kind of compare them.
Yeah, maybe I shoot some content and you could write some of it off, you know, who knows. But
absolutely.
But I thought it'd be cool. And then, like I said, we have Six Flag passes, so, you know, get up to Six Flags Over Texas.
Yeah, yeah. The original Six Flags.
Yeah.
I know, yeah. If you didn't
know. Yeah. And we haven't gone to that water park yet, which is like, it's actually across the street and down the freeway a little bit from the Six Flags Over Texas. So yeah, so that's one water park in Texas we haven't been to, but yeah, we're checking them off, man. We went down to Corpus and
I need
all
to hit
places.
Slitterbond and Galveston.
Yeah, actually,
it's been a while.
Actually,
I need to go over there for a day and just relax.
That's my wife and my son have been there, but I haven't been there yet. So yeah, and my daughter's been there.
Yeah, I'm gonna see if my brother
and my nephews
want to go down there and spend a day, and then maybe hit Moody Gardens too the next day, spend a weekend.
There you go.
Right next to each other.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, absolutely. And of course, you used to have the Lone Star Flight Museum there. Now
there's
a bigger and better version here at Ellington Field. Clear Lake.
That's right.
Yeah.
That was such a big move for them.
It was.
It's great for us because it's right there in our backyard. Yeah. You've been to quite a few events over there, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So. You know, and one of the last events that happened at the Galveston location was the TV shoot for the Discovery Channel for the Galacta Guys.
Right,
yeah. That was, that was July 1st. I guess that would have been 2012. So, yeah, we're shooting a reality TV show on the tarmac, you know, there at the Lone Star Flight Museum. You know, I mean, literally, I mean, if you, you know, and I could, you know, the video's out there. I mean, it aired on the Discovery Channel and Destination America for, like, you know, 5 years all the time. But, yeah, you could see my, you know, I was definitely sweating.
Yeah.
At some point, I pulled a wardrobe change, which is a very similar shirt, but it had a different Galacticos logo. So I literally am responsible for a flub, you know, for a contuity flub, you know, where I literally, at one point I'm wearing one shirt, then another point I'm wearing another shirt, and then I'm going back to the...
And people don't understand. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're like...
Yeah. So I caused that myself,
Oh, wow.
Yeah. But, yeah. Yeah. But, yeah.
Well, man, dude... Independence Day, wow, right around the corner.
Be an awesome weekend, man.
It will. You know, I hope everybody has off Monday. Not everybody does.
Right.
A lot of people got to go into work on Monday, and then they're off Tuesday, which is a little bit strange. But a lot of people put in the PTO and take the day off. And, you know, you still get to enjoy Saturday, Sunday, and then Tuesday. So enjoy that long weekend and, you know, definitely hit the water. It's hot. Get wet. Yeah, watch fireworks, have fun, plenty of entertainment. I'm excited. Like I said, coming off Outlaw Weekend, going straight into 4th of July, going into July in general, which is like the number one month of the summer.
Right.
July is it. Yeah, I'm excited.
Yes.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Heck yeah.
No, and you know, and I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everybody for their service, including you, my brother. Thank you for your service.
Thank you. Yeah, no, and thank you, everybody who's
seems,
served.
Seems
yeah.
appropriate to say right now. And thank everybody for listening. You know, we're happy to, you know, throw a couple events, give you a couple more reasons to come down to the waterfront capital of Texas this upcoming weekend. You know, literally events. I mean, there's events going on in Kima tonight. Lots of great music. I mean, you know, it's kind of hard because you can only pick a few to share. And, I picked a lot more than I even shared. But, you know, it is what it is, man. There's so much awesome live music going on. So many reasons to come down here. So many bars and restaurants with specials this upcoming weekend.
So many reasons to tune in because, yeah, next week I believe we got an awesome guest coming on. You know, he's president of a pretty prominent organization around here.
Very excited,
So hopefully that works out. We're always just so excited to have just our special guests come on the show and just tell us their stories and what they got going on. They're just pinnacles in the community. Yeah, so stay tuned in. We want to recap 4th of July. We hope you guys have, you know, a safe holiday weekend. And like I said, we've got an awesome guest coming on next week. So if you want to hear about anything that's on the water, anything going on, make sure and tune in on any podcast platform. And me and John are probably on there. Weekends on the Water, baby.
Hey, yeah. Thanks for listening. And have a great holiday weekend coming up.
Yeah, absolutely. Later, John.
Later on, man.
It's Weekends on the Water.
Thanks for listening to today's show.
The official podcast of the waterfront capital of Texas.
Sponsored by Water. Water. Much better than drinking sand.
Weekends on the Water.
Oh, well, let's make you.
Weekends on the Water. With Jordan Davlin of Jet Surf Houston and Scene Magazine publisher John Ennis.